Hello everyone! Welcome to part 2 of our video series. Here, we will take our 3D model sample from the last video and process it through our recommended software, Kirimoto. If you haven't done so already, please watch our first video where we prepared the 3D model of the coaster using onshape.com. Go to the App Store and add Kirimoto to your subscription list. Then, go back to your design and click the plus sign to add Kirimoto to your project. On the new tab that opens, a pop-up will automatically appear for you to import your designs. Select the model you wish to import. Alright, let's go through the left menu settings. First, ensure you're using Kirimoto in CNC milling mode. Under the setup menu, click devices to select the CNC Mill 1 option and click close. Click tools to add a new type of end mill. This is where your end mill measurements come in. I've previously added my 2mm end mill to my tools list, which can be edited here as well. If you're creating a new tool profile, do make sure you're checking off whether the end mill measurements are in metric units. The menu on the right is where we change the mill settings, and a small description can be found when you hover each field. For now, I'm going to uncheck the finishing stage so you can view the roughing on its own. My coaster will be made of wood, so I took the values from the Feeds and Speeds chart from CNC.com and entered the values here. A link to this reference page is in the description box. Click Slice to see how the toolpath looks like. Depending on the dimension of your mill and the dimension of your 3D model, you will need to do a bit of troubleshooting. For instance, you will notice on my design that the toolpath looks dashed instead of a complete circle. Let's click Preview to simulate the toolpath. Strangely, rather than just cutting along the circle, the toolpath jumps up and down as it passes through the circle. This is because in the roughing stage, a polygon is a faster cut. However, in a polygon, the width of that path isn't always 2mm wide, so the program thinks the mill won't make the cut. This isn't really the end of the world, but the toolpath is now longer, and our project is going to take too long to mill. To fix this, you have two options. The obvious one is to redesign the ridges to be wider, but as this is a software issue and not really an issue with your design, you can always tweak the software a little and change the tool dimension to be just a little skinnier than its actual width. Here, I'm going to change the diameter from 2mm to 1.95. Now, let's enable the finish stage. I'll increase the step over to 0.75 so the edges are smoother. Waterline targets the steeper curves of the model. Meanwhile, the linear X and Y finishing targets the shallower curves. This will take care of the fillets in our model. Click Slice again to generate the new path. Notice how busy the path became. The more lines you see, the more the mill travels, which means the longer the milling will take. Now, I don't really want the machine to mill the flat surfaces of the coaster. I can tell the machine to skip it by checking off curves only. We'll skip the drilling menu because our coaster doesn't need it. The next menu deals with cutout taps, which is turned off by default. If you're using a flat piece of wood as your stock material and a strong double-sided tape as your work hold method, then taps aren't really necessary. But for those of you who are using clamps to hold your stock down, once the outline of the project is cut, the model is free-floating and your coaster design will be out of whack. Here is where the tabs come in. Change the tab dimension to something strong enough to hold but easy enough to cut and click Slice again. Some of you may be wondering, what if my stock isn't exactly the thickness of my design? The toolpath isn't milling away the extra material. Here is where the stock menu comes in. Enter a rough measurement of your stock material. The stock volume will show up on your Kirimoto Arrange view. the model automatically floats to the top, so you need to change it to the bottom of the Mill 1 bed. Double-click the model so it's highlighted. A hidden menu will show up, showing you the dimension of your model. Pull out a calculator and subtract the stock height by the coaster's height. This is the Z offset. We are now ready to export the G-code. Under the preview function, click Export and save your NC file. This next part is optional, but if you're curious as to how the raw G-code looks like and ways to simulate the cut, then continue to the rest of this video. Open the G-code file you've just exported. You can view it using a code editor or simply using Notepad. Each line of text holds the X, Y, and Z translation instructions for the machine. You can copy and paste this code into a G-code simulator. We have provided a link in the description box to a G-code simulator we often use. Copy and paste the code into the text box and click Simulate. This is a good way to visualize your G-code, especially if your project will require multiple G-code files. As an example, here I copy and pasted G-codes for engraving and for cutting the outlines of some keychains. Here I can see if any alignments are off. This wraps up the Kirimoto CAM software. You can now take this NC file to your CNC Mill 1. I'll see you in the next video where I'll walk you through workhold methods, zeroing the axis, and running the mill.